Welcome back after the break, and now for a discussion on the newspaper headlines published from the National Capital. We have with us in our studio senior journalist Mr. K.G. Suresh.
Welcome to Breakfast Plus.
Morning, sir, and welcome to the show. Well, every paper is talking about the monsoon session, which begins today. The Tribune carries a headline, "House should not prejudge the 2G case," says the Prime Minister. And also, the Indian Express quotes him. He says, "The opposition has too many skeletons as well." A 39-day session it will be. It is expected to end on the 8th of September. And we see a lot of important, as many as 35 bills are to be taken up in this session itself. We talk of the Lokpal bill, the Women Reservation bill, the Land Acquisition bill, you name it. And we have almost every important work this time around. But then with the BJP talking of how many arrows we each of us has in his or her quiver, and also with the Prime Minister talking of the opposition skeletons in the cupboards, do we see the monsoon session somewhat a repeat of the winter session?
It should not happen like that. Yes, the Prime Minister was in an unusually combative mood yesterday. And the opposition's response too was, very combative. And from the war of words, it would appear that it's going to be a really stormy session. Issues are there. A lot of issues are there. From land acquisitions to price rise to terrorism to FDI in retail to the corruptions, farmers, land acquisition and all that, railway accidents are there.
Absolutely.
So, I mean, there is a lot of issues to be discussed. Now, in what spirit the House takes it out?
Right.
Now, I think that as both sides, I see a ray of hope in the sense that both sides said that yes, there should be discussions within the House. So there has to be, and both sides should be open to discussions. I don't think that, you see, at the end of the day, what did we achieve last time?
Nothing.
I mean, JPC, the entire you had the session almost being boycotted by the opposition, and finally the government had to give in and agree to a JPC.
Right, so both sides have lessons to learn.
Why can't we start the middle path straight away instead of having a confrontationist approach, disrupting parliament for 2-3 weeks and then finally come to, at any case we have to run parliament, and important legislations are there. The food security bill is there, land acquisition is there, a lot of bills, you know, involving the people's interests are there. So let them be open about it. In any case, the government is not in a minority or anything that it would fall down. So there is no sense of insecurity on that front. So let there be an open discussion. Let the truth come out. There is the issue of corruption. There is the issue of illegal mining. It involves all sides, you see. So it's not confined to, it's confined to the entire body politic of this country.
All right, the way it shapes up will
have
to be
seen. So I think that there has to be a very constructive approach on both sides to ensure that, you know, parliament, because the people's faith in parliament has to be restored.
And to also ensure that the backlog of those important, very vital bills is cleared very soon, though both sides have enough
ammunition. And Lokpal is one major issue, you know, they are going to be.
Absolutely, sir, and the whole country is waiting for it.
All right, sir, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining us on the show this morning.
Thanks very much.